Hello, my beautiful souls. Okay, so before we get started with your reading, I just want to share with you a fascinating website I was recently introduced to that helps you discover how compatible you are in relationships, how others perceive you, and also explains how to fully understand your natal chart through astrology and numerology. There is a ton of information waiting for you on this site to help you better understand love, your path, and to help you improve your life. I got my charts done and it is amazingly accurate and extremely informative. The website is called trulydivine.com and they are offering a 30% off discount for all of my subscribers. All you have to do is use code ZEN30 at checkout to receive your discount. I will provide the link and code in the description box below. So peace and love and happy learning. Now let's get started with your reading. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Zen Within Me. Okay, today's reading is going to be a love reading for Taurus Sun Moon Rising. So without further ado, my darlings, let's get into your reading. Okay, guides, guardians, ancestors, angels, and ancient gods, please give me clear and concise messages for Taurus Sun Moon Rising regarding their love life. Okay, what love messages do we have for Taurus at this time? What does Taurus need to know regarding their love life? Please continue to protect us, watch over us, and guide us always. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, we've got some messages, Taurus. Okay. So let's see. We're starting off with the High Priestess here. Okay. Then the Knight of Swords. Okay. Let's see. Four of Cups. And Page of Pentacles. Okay. So I'm seeing here for some of you, you want communication to come in from somebody, but you're feeling like, no, it's not happening. Like they're withdrawn. You have the urge to want to contact this person to just like swoop in and do the communicating yourself, but your intuition is telling you not to. So I'm feeling that you are pulling back from communicating with someone. And this can also be flipped energy here. So this could be, if you're waiting to hear from somebody, this could be their energy on you. But I'm feeling that this is going to resonate with more of you being the one that wants to communicate with someone, but because for reasons unknown with the person you're dealing with, you are feeling withdrawn and you like very much like you have to really pull back. Like I'm seeing for some of you, you have the phone in your hand, you're looking at the person's number and you're like, okay, you may even put in all the numbers and then you just won't press send, or you'll have written a text and then you'll just delete it. Like, never mind, forget it. You want to reach out to someone and make an offer, but you feel that they're not in it and you don't know why. Okay. You don't know why, like, this person, I'm feeling like for some of you, this person has, like, ghosted you or just cut them out of your life, and you never got closure as to why. So let's see. Can you give us some more details for Taurus's love life? What's going to happen here? Can you give us some clarity as to why they've been ghosted? Possible outcome. Okay, runner. Runner in a codependent relationship, fear of intimacy, listening to ego. Okay, so this person is basically running from you. They may have a fear of intimacy, or it could be something with their intuition here, okay, that they are listening to. So maybe they feel that there was something off about you that they didn't know about. Maybe they felt that you were pulling back at one point, and so then they're like, you know what, I'm just going to leave it alone, and I'm going to pull back. But you do want to make an offer towards this person. You do want to reach out towards this person. So can you please give us some more details as to why this person ghosted you, or what is going to come of this? Will there be communication in the future? Okay, last shuffle. Any other messages? Okay. Thank you. Okay, so we have here... Okay, So we have here outdated thinking, conditioning, replaying events over in your head. So like I said here, like this is basically what's going on here. Like you're thinking about things you want to reach out because you're not comfortable with not knowing here, okay? And you want to reach out, like you really do want to take action towards this person, but you keep pulling back because you may understand some of you why you've been ghosted and you're just replaying things over and over in your head. Like maybe I could have done this differently. Maybe I could have done that differently. Okay, maybe you were the one running and then when you were ready, they were like, no. And now you want to like reach out. Maybe you've tried to reach out and it's just, you're not getting that communication. It's like just quiet. Okay. And your intuition is just telling you, when you go to take the action, your intuition is telling you, just pull back, not yet. Okay, and then we have mirror. Mirroring each other, self-image, relationships reflect our wounds and introspection. So again, introspection here, replaying events over in your head. Like I said, this is something that you keep thinking about that you can't let go. I'm getting from that Knight of Swords energy. But we do have the butterfly, relationship evolving to the next phase, healing the inner child and growth. Okay, so I do feel there will eventually be communication here. Now I'm feeling it's going to be a while, but you will eventually get that closure. You will have that growth. You will have that communication here that comes in. Okay. So having said that, I'm actually going to pull some cards from the Moonology deck. Let's see if we can get an idea of when. When will Taurus get the communication that they are seeking? When will Taurus get the communication that they are seeking? Okay, so we have here, don't let pride get in your way. Full moon in Leo. Okay, so you may be dealing with the Leo. Look to see when is full moon in Leo. This is a timeless reading. It could also just be the next full moon phase. Okay, but don't let pride get in your way. Taurus, you tend to be very prideful, so I feel that message is for you. The end of a tough cycle approaches, full moon in Capricorn. Okay, so again, that's two full moons here. End of a tough cycle approaches, so I'm feeling for some of you it's very soon or the next full moon from when you watch this. Again, you could be dealing with a Leo or Capricorn, or it could be in the time of Leo, which is actually from when this is posted. I'm not sure if we're in Leo season yet, but I know it's like right around the corner if we aren't. Okay. Or when you're watching this time of Capricorn. Okay. Adjustments are required, third quarter moon. And communication is key, new moon in Gemini. So you may be dealing with a Gemini. And that's if you're dealing with a Gemini, then we have communication is key. This is what you're waiting for. Okay. So it could be by the next new moon phase that you will get this communication from your Gemini. All right. Let me pull some more cards here. What other messages do we have for Taurus regarding their love life? What does Taurus need to know regarding their love life? Okay, so we have here Capricorn. Coming up again, the energy around you is serious, materialistic, and hardworking. It bestows shrewdness and cautious ambition. So, if you're not dealing with a Capricorn, it could just be they have this energy of Capricorn. And then for the planet, we have the Sun. Beautiful. Your immortal spirit, purpose, and destiny is involved. So, the universe is telling you things are going to work out as they should in divine timing. Okay. So please keep that in mind because I do see the communication here. I do see the offer here, and I'm feeling the offer is like, let's get together. You know, I haven't seen you in a while. I haven't heard from you in a while, you know. And then we have relationship evolving to the next phase. So I do feel, like I said, you guys will get this communication. You will get this closure, and you know, you may have a shot at a second chance. It all depends on where you guys are in your lives at that point that you reconnect, okay? So let's get some letters and initials and see what letters and initials are relevant to Taurus at this time. Oh, Okay, well, I guess we're taking all of them. Okay. So we have the letter R. Person, place, or thing, however it connects you with your person. F. I'm getting a Frank and a Franz. I'm also seeing frozen yogurt. Also something with frozen. It could be ice cream. The movie Frozen. I don't know. Whoever may be a fan of that, or however that resonates. Or somebody's always freezing. Okay, the letter G here. We have the letter N, G. Well, the letter is N, G, so I'm sure that's relevant to someone. And again, it's like spelling out freezing here. U. E. Y. And the letter D. I'm seeing someone is like eyeing you. Someone is keeping their eyes on you. So, having said that, somebody might be checking out someone's social media or like driving by their house or something like that. However, like you need to keep someone in eyes view of you, even maybe having other people that know you, like spy. I'm also seeing, I see DYE, dye. Someone may dye their hair here. I'm seeing red, dyeing their hair red. So someone might be a redhead here. Also, run is spelled out. So somebody was definitely running away from something. I'm also seeing Fez. So if someone was a fan of that 70s show or Fez, that's also coming through as another connection with your person. Now, if you had a yes or no question, your answer is yes, because I know we have an N also, but we don't have NO, we have YE. So to me, that's more letters that spell yes than no. So I'm feeling strongly that your answer is a yes if you have a yes or no question. So will I hear from this person again? Yes. You will hear from this person again in divine timing, okay? The sun is going to shine on you guys. And the sun in the tarot is also happiness, success, and a joyous union, okay? Things shining bright, you know? Like the clouds part, and there is the sun making everything okay. So keep that in mind as well. All right. So, those are your messages, Taurus. Thank you so much for liking, sharing, watching, and subscribing. Peace and love, and I will see you in the next reading.